you, oh God, if there's anything that I've done or said that's not pleasing to you, oh God, I ask that you wash me and make me clean for your service. Father, I pray now, oh God, that you will allow your spirit to be so that the people can receive the word fresh from you. Remove me and replace me with your spirit, oh God, and allow it to be fresh now. Father, I pray for the heart to receive the word of God. I pray, oh God, that the word changes their spirits. Pray, oh God, that from this day, that doors be open for prosperity. Pray, oh God, that healing would take place this day.
Yes, Lord.
That they will begin to push forward because of the word of God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
I want you to turn your Bibles to the book of Acts, the 8th chapter. And we're going to start at the 26th verse. Acts 8, verse 26. If you're there, say, I'm here, Pastor Willis. Now, I need y'all to talk back to me now. I need y'all to talk back to me now. Can everybody just say amen?
Amen. Amen.
Look, let me pay attention. Everybody say amen. Can everybody say amen?
Amen.
All right, now if y'all don't talk to me, we're going to be in here all night.
Amen.
If I can't get somebody to say something back to me, y'all going to make me think y'all ain't listening. I got to keep going over the same points over and over again. So I need a talk church. Amen. Amen. But if y'all help me, I can get this and get a good sermon to you. And we can get on and go on laying on down. Amen. Ain't nothing like church and sleep. If you had a good service, boy, you can go to sleep. Everybody know what I'm talking about. After you ain't had a good sleep until you shouted and slain in the floor. You don't even remember getting up from the pew straight to the bed. Amen. Amen. Let's go into the scripture. The 26th chapter. And the angel of the Lord spake unto Philip, saying, Rise and go towards the south unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem to Gaza, which is desert. And he arose and went. Behold, a man of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under Candace, the queen of the Ethiopians, who had charge of all of her treasures and had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot, reading Elias. Esaias, the prophet. Then the Spirit said unto Philip, Go near and join thyself to this chariot. And Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Esaias and said, Understand thou what thou readest? And he said, How can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him at the place of the scriptures where he read this was this. He was led as a sheep to the slaughter, like a lamb dumb before his shearers, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, his judgment was taken away. And who shall declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth. And the eunuch answered Philip and said, I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this? Of himself or of some other man? And then Philip opened his mouth and began at that same scripture and preached unto him. And as they went their way, they came unto a certain water. And the eunuch said, see here this, see here is water. What doth hinder me to be baptized? You may be seated now. I want to stop right there. What doth hinder me to be baptized? Now, in this story, listen to this. In this story, there's only two characters. There was a man of God by the name of Philip. Now, I need you to understand, Philip was no great prophet. He was not a mighty name. He was not big and knowing like the T.D. Jakes's of the world. He was just an average worshiper. Sometimes today, we feel as if for God to use us, we must have such a tall status. Got to have a title behind our name. Our name might got to have bishop or prophet this or evangelist this. But Philip lets us know that God can use anyone that will listen. Church, your ears have to be keen to the voice of God.
Yeah.
Lives can be changed if you will hear God.
Yes. Yes.
Situations can turn around if there was just an ear to hear God.
Yes.
But baby, let me tell you something. Folk don't want to hear God anymore. Oh, don't nobody want to talk to me in this room. Oh, they want to hear what President Trump got to say. They want to hear what this one has to say. They want to, but they don't want to hear the Lord's voice. I wonder if there's anybody in the room that still seeks after the voice.
Yes, sir.
Of
yes,
God.
Yeah.
The Bible said that the angel of the Lord spoke to Philip.
Uh-huh.
And Philip moved when the angel of the Lord spoke.
Uh-huh.
We have a problem in the body of Christ when we can't hear God.
Yes. Come on.
Oh, don't nobody want to talk.
Come on.
Everybody want to talk.
Huh? Come on.
Don't nobody want to listen.
Yeah. Come on.
Everybody got the remedy for your life.
Come on.
But prayer is obsolete.
Come on.
Oh, I ain't never seen so many no praying preachers in my entire life. Never seen so many prophets that didn't know how to go and turn down their plate.
Come on.
When is there going to be a yearn to seek after who God is?
Yes,
don't you know when you learn who God is, you learn the mystery of the miracle. When you learn who God is, Philip knew how to seek after the voice of God. He didn't go left. He didn't go right until he heard the voice of God. He didn't look up or look down until he heard the voice of God. I found out that when I move in my own power, I make the most mistakes.
Yeah.
I found out when I don't take my time and let the Holy Ghost speak to me, I find myself digging myself in a ditch that's hard to get out of. Sometimes we need to take the time.